Hello, God bless you. This is Prophet Daniel from Daniel Multi Ministries, and this is our first week of the Great Prophetic School. I'm really excited. Are you ready for all the information you're about to receive? And are you ready to work with it? Let's pray. Father, let your power, let your spirit of wisdom and knowledge flow. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now, do you know the good news? Now, this is the week one of our lectures. And this title of the course is called How to Activate and Sharpen Your Prophetic Calling. And under this one, what you are going to achieve is the meaning of prophecy, the meaning of a prophet. And the signs for you to know that a prophecy is coming to edify an individual, a prophecy is coming to move somebody to their destiny. I'm also going to show you how to run with a prophetic word. And as you have the prophetic calling over your life, how your words that you speak will be able to come to pass. And I'm going to give you about 10 signs of the things you need to do for you to be seen as a good and a genuine and a true prophet. Now, the course materials you need for today is your guarding and protecting your prophetic word book, whether it's a soft copy or a hard copy. You get your notebook, and as a matter of fact, you will get your Bible. So these are your materials you need right now. Make sure all of them are ready. Now, number one, what is prophecy? According to the Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary, a prophecy simply means knowledge of the future. Knowledge of the future from a divine source. In other words, knowledge of the future obtained from a divine source. So prophecy simply means I'm speaking about the future. I'm speaking about what is ahead of me or what is ahead of you. I'm speaking about the unknown future. So a prophet comes to speak about your future. Countless number of times we've met many people, and I've met many people who said, "Prophet, can you predict my future?" Do you know something? Prophecy is not a prediction, because the word prediction simply means indicates by a sign. So for a prediction, you can say something about the future based on a sign. But by prophecy, we don't prophesy based on a sign. Just check this thing. Elisha gets to Samaria and there is famine on the land in 2 Kings chapter 7. And the word of the Lord comes over the life of Elisha. And Elisha prophesies and says, "Tomorrow by this time, a seah of flour will be sold for a shekel." In other words, there's going to be abundance of food. Everybody on there says, "Elisha, you are mad. You are not correct." Why? Because there is famine, and how can there be abundance within 24 hours? So if Elisha had spoken or indicated by prediction, by the signs, he couldn't have prophesied. But he didn't check the signs over there that there was no food. But he tapped into a divine source. So as a prophet, as somebody with a prophetic calling, let your source always be by divine source. If you check by signs, you will end it on the way and you will not be able to fulfill the prophecy. The same way, prophecy in the Greek word is called prophetes, prophetia, prophetia. And what's the meaning for prophetia? It simply means to speak about the future. So by now, you have seen that prophecy is about the future. It's about the moment from now. In the Greek, anytime a word starts from P-R-O, it speaks about the future. You know that most of our English lexicons started from the Greek Orthodox. And now hear me. So if prophecy, it has something to do with the future, pro-future, then example, when you're about to read a book, we have something about a profile. Why? A profile of the book. What I want to know before. a profile. So, you know, things about PRO means something in advance, or PRE means pray in advance. So never forget about this. Never forget about this. Because a profile of a person means the person I've never seen before, but I'm going to know something about their lives. So example, a prologue means I want to know the logos before. I want to know the written word before. Now, who is a prophet? A prophet is someone who speaks under the inspiration of God to reveal God's agenda and intention to humanity. Wow, that's amazing. Let's break it down right now. Number one, a prophet speaks under the inspiration of God. So for you to work in the office of the prophet, what you need to understand is this. Never forget to move under the inspiration of God. So if you're a prophet and your source is not from God, there is a big problem. So a prophet, your source is supposed to be from God. You are supposed to be inspired by God. Okay, example. I meet someone who is sick with cancer in my church. She's called Mimi. I pray for her and I speak to her and I tell her, the Lord ministers to me to let you know that the cancer will vanish. After surgeries and everything, she goes on there, do a checkup, and they tell her no more chemotherapy. If I was not inspired, I wouldn't have told this woman that your cancer will leave. Because when I check a condition, there is nothing that will tell me she is going to be well. But because I move by the inspiration, not my inspiration, because my own inspiration can let me down. But hear me one more time. But by the inspiration of God. So which means we move, we speak as a prophet. Like you, I'm speaking to you right now, embarking on this course. You move not by your inspiration. Sometimes you check your finances and your finances will tell you, you cannot make it. You cannot do it well. How can you make it? Because the account is red. But do you know the good news? One more time, do you know the good news? The good news is this. I move by the inspiration. So someone who speaks about the inspiration of God to reveal God's secrets, God's hidden agenda and intention to humanity. So having this particular revelation, you need to understand and you need to know your assignment as a prophet is to speak about God's agenda. But this day and age, the problem going on in the prophetic office is because prophets are speaking about their own agenda. I've always said to myself, I will never speak about my agenda. Why? Because my agenda can be wrong. My agenda can be bad. And my agenda might not be what God is looking for. But if I speak the agenda of God, I will change lives. I will turn people's life around. So will you. So as you are embarking on this course, the agenda, the secret, the main reason for you to be in the prophetic office is one thing: to reveal God's hidden agenda. Okay. Now, prophet, one more time. Prophet in the Greek is simple. It's called prophetes. And what's the meaning? An inspired speaker. So everything about prophecy is inspiration. Do you know the reason why? Because there's going to be a time you are supposed to prophesy and you are supposed to declare something. And if you are not inspired by God, you will doubt what you are going to speak. Now this one, you can find it in my prophetic book. That you might not even believe what you're about to say. Because you check the condition and the condition tells you it's false, it's wrong. But the Lord is telling you, tell them it's the truth. That's why Apostle Paul speaks in his epistle. He says, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Never look at the condition, but look at what God is saying about the condition. So that's prophecy. Now, if prophecy is not by prediction, number one, never prophesy, never speak by signs. It says, if you look at the weather, you cannot sow. But never look at the weather, never look around and speak. Now, the reason why prophecy is important is that the Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20, let's read it right now. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20, that the New Testament church, the New Testament church, Ephesians, I'm going to open it right now. The New Testament church is so amazing. Do you know the reason? I'm come to say something to you right now. Ephesians chapter 2, verse number 20, I read. It says, the New Testament church is built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, with Jesus Christ himself as the chief cornerstone. Do you know the meaning? It says, this New Testament, our lives are built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets. I guess you heard it before, or I guess you've not heard it before. If the foundation is on the prophets, then prophets are very important in this our dispensation. The foundation. Do you know a foundation? Before you build a house, you build a foundation. So if what you are building in this New Testament, your life, whatever you do, is not built on the foundation of the prophets, it can crumble. The Bible says in the book of Chronicles, let's read it right now. I'm coming somewhere. I have great information for you. You don't miss this one. Tell everybody to sign up. The book of Chronicles. When you go to the book of Chronicles, let's go to the second book of the Chronicles. When you go to the second book of the Chronicles, you are going to see something amazing, something unusual that you are going to really enjoy. Second Chronicles chapter 20 verse 20, let me read. It says, early in the morning, they left for the desert of Tekoa. As they set out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, listen to me, Judah, and people of Jerusalem. Have faith in the Lord, your God, and you'll be upheld. Believe in God and you'll be established. Have faith in his prophets, and you will succeed. Wow. Let me end it there. He says, believe in God and you shall be established. Believe in his prophets and you will prosper. So, and now, Apostle Paul, in his epistles writing to the Ephesians church or Ephesus church, he says the foundation is on the apostles and the prophets. And now, in the Old Testament, it says prosperity, success comes when you believe the prophet. So prophecy, prophets are really important for the prosperity, for the building, for the elevation of an individual, especially in this new dispensation. And it says, and Jesus himself is the cornerstone. So Jesus is at the corner, being the cornerstone, making sure that all is right, but there needs to be a foundation. And the foundation is the prophets. Hear me one more time. The prophetic office is important, it's very powerful, it's very great. Now let's continue. Now, why do I need a prophet? And why do somebody need a prophet? And why do you need prophecy in your life? Let me give you the answer. The answer is in Amos chapter 3, verse 7. 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 Are you enjoying it so far? The information is great. is great. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. I read one more time. Let's go. It says, surely the sovereign Lord does nothing. Then it goes on to say, without revealing his plans to his servants, the prophet. Wow. Is this in the Bible, Prophet Daniel? Yes. Surely the sovereign Lord does nothing. Then it becomes a big problem. Hey, if God will not do anything, nothing, why? Okay. He will do nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophet. Do you know the meaning? The only way God can do something is to reveal his plans to his servants, the prophet. So if a prophet does not speak, the agenda of God does not appear. That's why I told you, a prophet, make sure the agenda of God comes. So if a prophecy comes, you receive a prophecy, or you give a prophecy, you be my student, you give a prophecy, and it does not come to reveal the agenda of God, you are setting yourself up to be a false prophet. Because God does everything by revealing to his servants, the prophet. So if the prophet speaks, God is doing something. Or if God is doing something, he reveals to the prophet. Never bring out a prophetic message that is not about the agenda of God. When it comes, it's supposed to uplift somebody. It's supposed to destroy the plans of the enemy. What's the agenda of God? The agenda of God is revealed in the manifesto of Jesus in John chapter 10, verse 10. It says, Satan comes to kill, steal, and destroy. Now, let's see the agenda of God. I've come to give you life. So everything centered about God is to bring life. There are many times people receive prophecies and it doesn't come to give them life. It's a problem. A prophecy can be given, and that prophecy can, as a matter of fact, be a prophecy. Maybe the prophet seen that there is death around your life or cancer, but you know the good news. The prophet is supposed to cancel it for you. When I was young, I went to a prophetic meeting and the prophet was prophesying. He calls one woman. He tells the woman, you are going to be in jail. You are going to die. You will never make it in life. And the prophet never prays for the woman. The woman leaving the church crying. This is wrong. The agenda of God is to bring safety. God's plan.